There are three lights and four buttons. The first light is the power light that will go on when the unit is correctly plugged in. The timer light is on when the timer is engaged to turn off the unit after it's been on for an hour. This is just so the unit doesn't stay on overnight and you forget to turn it off. The heating light will go on once the unit is heating. Now, when we turn it on here with the bottom left hand side button, I will show you two temperatures. The one on the left is what the unit is at currently, and the one on the right is the preset temperature, which is basically the temperature you had it on last time before you turned it off. You can change this temperature if you want to vaporize at a different temperature with the two buttons here on the right. So very simple. For temperature settings what range would be best to vaporize at, you can go to our blog at blog.torontovaporizer.ca. There's a bit more detail there, and all you need to do is just search temperature settings for vaporizing. For the button here on the top left hand side, that's the menu button. If you press it once, it will go into the sound menu. You can turn on or off the sound, so every time you press the button it will make a sound. You press it again, you can set the auto shut off function to 3.5 hours or 3 hours, depending on how long you want the unit to be on before it automatically shuts itself off. Now I would recommend you just standard keep this at 1 hour, or if you have very long vaping sessions, just keep it at a higher timing based on your needs. If you press it for the third time, it will just get to the temperature setting again, which you can do off the regular display too. You don't need to go into menu with that. If you press it one more time, you can switch between Fahrenheit and Celsius. And you can see the heating light periodically just flashes there. That's just to keep the temperature stable. Now that we know how the display works and the unit has reached the desired temperature level, let's assume we want to vaporize at 190 degrees Celsius. We can go ahead and load the Cyclone Bowl with the botanical. Now this is some fresh botanical. It just has a natural brown color to it. And in order to get that to the perfect consistency, we always recommend with every one of our vaporizers because they are just perfectly calibrated for vaporizers, and they will grind up your botanical to that perfect consistency to make the vaporization process as efficient as possible. Now, other grinders or coffee grinders will do the job of grinding up your botanical, but because it's not that perfect consistency, every time you vaporize, you might waste a few percent of your botanical, which is definitely costly over time. So that's why we recommend a Zeus grinder. Now we can go ahead and fill the Cyclone Bowl about 2/3 of the way up. The see-through part, here you can see it. So 2/3 of the way, a little bit more than middle, you want to fill it up. And all you need to do now is you place it on top here, and notice there's no pressure needed. It all sits in perfectly. And you take the whip and place it on top. Now the air pathway is all inside the glass, which makes it very, very nice and smooth and flavorful. And as soon as you take a draw, the air will go from the bottom of the unit through the heating chamber and generate the vapor when it gets to the botanical and come towards you. Now, the only thing to know to do with this unit is after a month or two of use, you might want to clean this, or even earlier if you like it to keep it cleaner. In order to do that, soak this whole whip In a bowl with hot water for about 5 minutes. That will loosen up the medical grade tubing, which also says non-toxic here. It will loosen it up and it will allow you to take the elbow adapter out much easier. If you just try to take it out without heating this, 10% of the time it will snap and you'll have to go out and get another elbow adapter. Now, the steering tool is a nice tool after you vaporize this for, let's say, 10 minutes you just want to steer it up a little just to make sure you heat the botanical from every angle to make sure that the vaporization is even more efficient. You use that and you can vaporize the same batch for another few minutes. As long as you get vapor, then you're vaporizing, and if you want more information, you can obviously refer to our blog. The next option is the aroma dish. Now, every unit comes with some potpourri on default, so you can put that on after you vaporize, and if you don't want to bother anybody in your household with the odor of your vaporizing, then you can just use this right after you're done to make the room smell much fresher. And depending on the essential oils that you buy from your local health food store, you can just drop a few drops on top and that will make the room smell very fresh and nice. I hope you found the V-Tower Vaporizer How It Works video useful. This unit is a great fit for any person looking for a simple and straightforward low-cost vaporizer. Remember, this unit is assembled in Canada and therefore features outstanding manufacturing quality. And the glass-on-glass vaporization also ensures that the vapor is very good.